Friends, welcome to the English class. I am your English educator Priyanka Mishra. Today we are going to continue with chapter number 3, Tarot's Reward, from pages 32, 33 and page number 34. So let's begin. What happened in the previous video? We have learned that tarot filled a picture of Sake from the waterfall and he ran towards his home. So let's see what happens next. Only one swallow of the liquid, he stopped shivering and did a little dance in the middle of the floor. So his father took only a sip of sake and shivering, jo wo kaap rahe the. He stopped shivering, kaapna band ho gaya, and he was so happy. His father was so happy and delighted after having a sip of sake that he started to dance, he started to enjoy. That afternoon, a neighbor stopped by for a visit. Taro's father politely offered her a cup of the sake. The lady drank it greedily and thanked the old man. Then Taro told her the story of the magic waterfall. Thanking them for the delicious drink, she left in a hurry. By the nightfall, she had spread the story throughout the whole village. So what happened? All of a sudden, by chance, a lady came to their hut to visit them. And when she came to visit them, what happened? Taro's father offered her a cup of sake, offered the drink of sake to have her, because it was very cold there, and if he would give a sake to anyone, they would feel warm from the chilling winter. So his father offered the sake to that lady, and that lady drank the sake and she was very happy, and even she thanked the old man, she thanked the Taro's father. And after thanking them, what happened? She went away from there in hurry. And once she went away from there, what she did? She spread to the whole village that she had drank sake in Taro's house. Taro's father offered him sake. And what happened? Taro even told that lady that how he had got sake from the waterfall, from that magic waterfall. So she spread all this news to the whole village. Now let's see what happens. That evening there was a long procession of visitors to the woodcutter's house. Woodcutter's house means Taro's house. People made a line, procession means line. Sab log katar laga ke, line laga ke, unke ghar ke bahar khade ho gaye. Each man heard the story of the waterfall. What was the story of the waterfall? That he got sake instead of cold water from that waterfall. And took a sip of the sake. So everybody took a sip of the sake from Taro's house to avoid cold from the chilling winter. In less than an hour, the pitcher was empty. So the pitcher in which Taro brought the sake from that magical waterfall, in less than an hour, sake was empty, because so many people took a sip of sake from that pitcher, almost the whole village. Next morning, Taro started for work even earlier than the morning before. He carried with him the largest pitcher he owned, for he intended first of all to go to the waterfall. When he reached it, he found to his great surprise all his neighbors there. They were carrying pitchers, jars, buckets, anything they could find to hold the magic sake. Then one villager knelt and held his mouth under the waterfall to drink. He drank again and again and then shouted angrily, "Water! Nothing out water! Nothing but water!" Others also tried, but there was no sake, only cold water. So the next morning, Taro decided to go a bit earlier than ever. So in the very early morning, he went for the forest. And that day what he did, he carried with him the largest pitcher which he was having at his home, because it was the cold winter, and the sake he brought in the pitcher that was finished, that was consumed by the villagers. So he thought, let me go a bit earlier and I'll today bring sake in a more bigger pitcher than before, so that everybody could had it. But when he went there, what did he saw? There was a long queue of people standing near the waterfall. Why? To fill pitcher. To fill the pitcher with sake. So whatever they found at their home, jug, mugs, whatever they were having, buckets, jars, pitchers, they took with them to fill pitcher in it. And one man knelt down, and when he took a sip of water in his mouth from that waterfall to drink, what did he found to his surprise? He found that it was cold water, not sake. He got angry that it is water, it is normal water, not sake. Then what happened? Others were shocked. That Taro told that he got the sake from this waterfall only. So when others tried, they also found that it was only cold water and not sake. Okay. We have been tricked, shouted the villagers. The villagers got very angry and they told that we have been deceived, we have been cheated. Now they got very angry. Taro ne hame bewakoof banaya, humse jhoot bola hai. Where is Taro? Let us drown him in this waterfall. Matlab duba do is waterfall mein Taro ko. But Taro had been wise enough to slip behind a rock. He saw everything, and what he did, you can see in the picture, students. He hid behind a rock because he knew that they were very angry at that time. And he saw how things were going. He was nowhere to be found. So he understood that they are very angry, and what he did, he hid behind the rock. Okay. So muttering their anger and disappointment, when you are very angry, you say something very slowly, that is called muttering. Okay. The villagers left the place one by one. Taro came out from his hiding place. Was it true? He wonders. Was the sake a dream? So he also got surprised that the villagers came here to fill sake in their pitchers, jars, mugs and buckets, and they are very angry because they have found only cold water from the waterfall. So was it a dream? The previous night I got sake and filled my pitcher. So Taro was also very surprised. He was also wondering what is wrong. Once more he caught a little liquid in his hand. So again from the waterfall he took a little liquid in his hand, and what he did, he drank it. It was the same fine sake. So when he drank, what did he find? It was sake only, not cold water. To the thoughtful son, the magic waterfall gave delicious sake. So now finally the real thing of the story has come out, that to this son, to this thoughtful son, to this hardworking son, to only this son, the waterfall gave the delicious sake and not to others. Because when others tried, they got only cold water. But again, when Taro tried, he got that sake, the drink. To everyone else, it gave only cold water. Okay. So the story of Taro and his magic waterfall reached the Emperor of Japan. So whoever was the king of Japan at that time, this story that a magic has happened, the waterfall gave Taro not cold water, but it gave the liquid sake. So this news reached to the Emperor of Japan, to the king of Japan. And what he did, he sent for the young woodcutter and rewarded him with 20 pieces of gold for having been so good and kind. So the emperor gave 20 pieces of gold to Taro as a reward. Why? Because he has been so kind to everyone. If Taro wanted, he could keep that pitcher full of sake with him. But he offered to everyone in that chilling cold winter, and everybody was feeling warm after taking a sip of sake. So Taro has been kind to everyone, and that is why the king of Japan rewarded him with 20 pieces of gold. Then he named the most beautiful fountain in the city after Taro. So the most beautiful fountain in the city was named after Taro. Its name was kept as Taro. This said the emperor was to encourage all children to honor and obey their parents. So why did the emperor kept the most beautiful's name as Taro? Because children will come to learn to respect their parents and obey their parents. Okay, so a Japanese story retold, already told you that it is a Japanese story. Hope you understood this story. Thank you.